Lee was the most humble, soft-spoken gentleman you would ever know. He never took things terribly seriously. He enjoyed people. He was inquisitive. He loved learning new things and going to hear new music and read books. And he was just the most down-to-earth guy you would ever meet. And I'm very lucky that I was married to him for almost 36 years. Lee was diagnosed with stage 2 breast cancer. He had 17 lymph nodes removed, but his organs were clear. And he was also estrogen positive, HER2 negative. He had felt a small lump in his breast and never said anything to me about it. It was almost 6 months from the time Lee initially felt this lump and to when he actually went to a surgeon. The day that Lee went back for the follow-up to get the results, he was informed that he had breast cancer. And of course, like all days like that, you remember them. They're seared in your memory. Lee walked in the house, and at the time, only my son and I were at home. And he walked in, and choking back the tears, he said, "I have breast cancer." It's not something anybody ever expects to hear. Certainly, though, for a man, it's not something that we ever imagined would happen. He was only 48 years old. As I said, he was the pinnacle of health. And we just stood in the kitchen in a huddle in tears and began the journey. And once the diagnosis came, we sought out the best advice that we could find. And Susan G. Komen was certainly at the top of our list. They have great resources for us online. There were resources through the local affiliate. When he finished his treatments, he was declared cancer-free. Ultimately, he was diagnosed with metastatic disease, which was about 7 years after his initial diagnosis. Living with metastatic cancer, breast cancer, is definitely a life-changing experience. When Lee was initially diagnosed with that, even knowing that there was no cure for his breast cancer, he still kept this unbelievably positive attitude throughout. When he was diagnosed with stage 4, the breast cancer had spread to his liver, his lungs, his bones. It was in his spine, it was in his femur, it was in his skull. That was earth-shattering news because he had lived 7 years since his initial diagnosis and had lived very well and very healthy and a full life. And it just, we didn't expect this. We didn't think it was gonna happen again. Lee lived almost 5 years with metastatic disease, and if I could be half the person that he is, that he was, in the way that he lived with breast cancer, he was such a good teacher for all of us. He always said, even in his very last days, he said, "Kath, it can always be worse. It can always be worse." It was our kids who really are the truly blessed ones to have that kind of a father, to see him at his lowest points, you know, that a person can have, and still smile and joke. He just was so positive and upbeat and just never allowed himself a minute of pity. What a gift to our kids to be able to live like that and to die like that, you know, for them to see that kind of courage and strength is remarkable. It's cancer, and we can get cancer anywhere, and you know, men are no different than women in that regard when it comes to breast cancer. And I think we as women have a responsibility to get that message out. We have to take care of everybody to help get us closer to that day. And I think Susan G. Komen is definitely doing it.
I'm considered stage 4 cancer, and I live with that every day. Stage 4 breast cancer, I live with that every day. It doesn't hold me back. It makes things all that more meaningful. You know, everything in life and everything I do, the people I love and the people who I know are with me every step of the way, it just gives me strength and gives me meaning, gives meaning to the fight that I go through. I've been in a clinical trial dealing with an experimental drug. It's a PARP inhibitor. I'm in a blind study, so I'm not positive I had it, but my cancer has improved tremendously, and that could be the reason why. So I think we're on the verge of a lot of breakthroughs. Maybe I experienced one. We won't know for a while, but I'm very happy so far to report that maybe something new has made a difference and saved my life.